My name is Jose Montes, principal at Firebaugh High School. Please stand and remain standing as our graduates enter to the processional music. Immediately following the processional, we ask that you remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance and the National Anthem. At this time, I would like to call this year's student body president, Kayla Murillo, to lead us in the flag salute.
Thank you, Dr. Montes. Audience, please stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. Graduates and guests, please place your right hand over your heart. Face the flag. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Nice job. I go down now?
Thank you, Kayla. You may all be seated. Good afternoon once again. As the principal of Firebaugh High School, and on behalf of the Lynwood Unified School District Board of Education, the great students and faculty of Firebaugh High School, I welcome you to today's graduation ceremony. Before we continue our program, let me take a moment to introduce you to our guests. From the Lynwood Unified School District Board of Education, President Maria G. Lopez. Woo-hoo. Clerk Dr. Alma Karina Castro. Woo-hoo. Member Gary Hardy Jr. Member Julian del Rio Calleros. And Superintendent Dr. Gudiel R. Crossway. From the Lynwood Unified School District, Assistant Superintendent of Educational Services, Dr. Shauna Dinkins. Assistant Superintendent of Human Resources, Dr. Brian Lucas. Assistant Superintendent of Technology and Innovation, Dr. Patrice Gittes Bungle. Gittes Rebungle, sorry, I apologize. Chief Business Official, Mr. Gregory J. Fromm. Director of Secondary Education, Ms. Christine Arostegui Manson. We also have directors here from the Lynwood Unified School District. If you could please stand to be acknowledged. Thank you. Now, please welcome back Kayla to give her ASB President speech.
Good afternoon, family, friends, teachers, staff, and graduates. Thank you all for taking the time to join us today in this glorious celebration. My name is Kayla Murillo, the 2020-2021 Executive ASB President. Today, I stand before you all to congratulate the class of 2021 for making it through these amazing 4 years of high school. I want to start off by thanking the people who have supported me and help me flourish into the person that I am today. The first and most important person I want to thank is my mother. Although she is not physically here with me today, I wanted to thank her for always pushing me to be the most kind and humble version of myself possible. Next, I want to thank my biggest supporter, Paul. Thank you for always taking care of me and never leaving me alone despite our hardships. You are the person who I hold dearest to my heart because you have shown me that anything is possible and no dream is too big. Thank you for teaching me the true meaning of family. I love you, brother. Thank you to my cousins, Ricky and Diana, for taking me in as one of their own and always supporting my goals. Thank you to my nieces and nephews for bringing me endless joy, and I hope that one day I can serve as a role model for you all. I love you guys so much. Thank you to the ASB program that has allowed me the privilege and platform to spread positivity throughout my 4 years of high school. The time, effort, and passion that my ASB family puts into every event is remarkable. I am so proud of each and every one of you. Natalie, thank you for being the sunshine in my life. I know you're not the best with words, but you have never failed to make me smile when I feel down. Evelyn, my role model, thank you for always being on top of me about staying motivated in school and pushing me to do better. MIT is going to be lucky to have you. Thank you, Jocelyn and Cynthia, for being amazing friends and always giving me a shoulder to cry on. Ms. Frizzell and David, you guys are the most passionate, hardworking, and kind people that I have ever met. Thank you for supporting me since day one. Next, I want to thank all the amazing staff and programs on our campus. Shout out to EduCare for being ASB's biggest supporter. Thank you, Ms. Magali. Your hard work does not go unnoticed. The next shout out goes to Mrs. Storga. She has guided and supported us since the first day we walked through the gates our freshman year. Thank you. Ms. Camateros and the College and Career Team, thank you for your guidance and support. Teachers, thank you for being our motivation and helping us flourish into the amazing students we are today. Shout out to some of my many favorites, Ms. Forbes, Mr. J, Ms. Zaragoza, and Ms. Reynoso. Thank you to everyone who is a part of our FHS community. Every single one of you is an important member of our campus. The last shout out goes to class of 2021. Thank you for being the reason behind all the planning, decorating, and passion behind all our events and activities. This year was extremely difficult, but if we can get through that, we can get through anything. Before me, I not only see graduates, I see future lawyers, doctors, entrepreneurs, soldiers, etc., who are going to change the world. I want to end this by saying to use your struggles as your motivation for your future success, and most importantly, always stay humble and treat people with kindness and respect. And that's all for today. Go Falcons! Thank you. Now please welcome Cynthia Erazo Cabrera to give her senior class president speech.
Good evening, Firebaugh High School community, and thank you for joining us today to celebrate Firebaugh High School's class of 2021 graduation. To begin, I'd like to give a big thank you to my biggest supporters, my parents. Gracias, mamá y papá, por todo su apoyo. Este es solo el comienzo de muchos más logros. I would also like to give a big shout out to all the exceptional Firebaugh staff. Your work does not go unnoticed. Thank you to Ms. Rosella and Ms. Forbes for their tireless efforts in assuring this year's graduating class could get the best experience possible. Thank you to our administrators, Mr. Montes, Mr. Ochoa, Dr. Miles, and Ms. Ancona. You always give us the platform for our voices to be heard. Thank you to Mr. Ramirez, Ms. Borrayo, and Ms. Torres from the Lynwood Alumni Association, who always kept me motivated and taught me some very valuable lessons. Thank you to my best friends, Wendy, Emily, and Natalie, who even when I couldn't see it, reminded me of my potential. Last but not least, thank you to Mrs. Storga and Ms. Camateros for always giving us that extra push to do better and get our college work done. 4 years ago, we walked into Marco Antonio Firebaugh High School, dreading our first day as freshmen on this campus, at which, in comparison to our previous schools, seemed enormous. Now we are walking across this stage and making sure that our dreams turn into reality and we're going on to bigger and better things. The day for us to finally graduate seemed to be so far away and seemed to be just a distant dream. It even felt as if it would never come, but now it has. Some of us will be heading towards community colleges, Cal States, UCs, other public and private universities, trade schools, the military, and others will be heading down different paths. But I want to remind you all that wherever you go and whatever you do, give it your all and don't give up when things get tough. I think there's one thing that our senior class has taught us is to expect the unexpected, but most importantly, to have hope and show resilience. This class has demonstrated that we do not lack any of these characteristics, but more so, we exceed these exceptions. Within you all, I see so much potential, and you are ready for whatever the world throws at you, and you will keep going. Contrary to what the world keeps trying to tell us, you do not need to have the answers right now. It's probably better if you don't. And while you might actually never have the answers, don't worry because you can spend as much time as you need to figure it out. I know going on to the world is scary and that we will encounter things and live through experiences that we never imagined, but do not let the idea of fear hold you back. Don't be afraid to be the person who asks for condiments at restaurants for that because you will never get what you want. Make sure to always speak up for yourself and make sure your voice is heard. With that, I leave you all. It was an honor to serve as your senior class president. I can't wait to see all the great things you will accomplish and wish you success in your future endeavors. I wish you all the best of luck and remember, once a Falcon, always a Falcon. Thank you. Now we'll welcome back Mr. Montes.
Great job.
Good afternoon once again. I would once again like to congratulate the class of 2021. The worldwide pandemic is an event that has altered our course in ways that we could not have imagined. However, as difficult and impactful as it has been on our lives, the compassion and resilience of the class of 2021 must be celebrated. Throughout the year, our students have demonstrated that despite our community being impacted greatly by the pandemic, they found ways to support and encourage each other. The meaning of the word compassion became clearly embodied by the class of 2021 through their selfless acts of care and kindness for each other. Students checked in on each other throughout the year to ensure that families were healthy and safe. They helped each other with difficult school assignments during distance learning. Students connected with their teachers despite the distance barrier. These were just a few of the ways in which students demonstrated a genuine and authentic care and understanding for each other. This quality is admirable and exemplary. The class of 2021 has not only achieved great accomplishments under extremely difficult circumstances, they have demonstrated a resilience that teaches all of us about the power of genuine care for our fellow humans. You have persevered even when you felt like giving up in the most difficult times. You kept going even when you encountered hardships. The class of 2021 is unique in its strength and in its perseverance. You have emerged as a group of young people with unwavering determination and vision. Your resolve to complete the journey you began 4 years ago demonstrates that you can overcome any obstacles that you may encounter in life. As you embark on the next stage of your life, I would like you to take this thought with you. You have the power to positively influence the lives of others in more ways than you can imagine. The great American writer and poet Maya Angelou once said, "I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." Graduates, your positive influence on others is great. Your positive impact on the world is powerful. Your efforts and your compassion will help and guide others to help them fulfill their highest aspirations. Remember that your words have the power to uplift others by helping them see what they may not see in themselves. Your actions inspire others by actively demonstrating how you can take care of others' humanity and dignity. Today, we celebrate a group of graduates who have endured a year that made us all face some of the most difficult challenges imaginable. We also celebrate a group of graduates who will continue to inspire each of us to keep giving the best of ourselves to improve the world we share. Graduates, always remember the memories and friendships you have made at Firebaugh High School. Foster those friendships and work towards making new memories with the people who have embarked on this journey with you. Remember the words of wisdom your parents, family members, and teachers have instilled in you, and use them to guide you through your new journeys. Remember that you are a Firebaugh Falcon and that your impact is powerful as you spread your wings. Congratulations, class of 2021. The honor of class salutatorian is awarded to the student with the second highest grade point average in the graduating class. It is my great honor to introduce to you this year's salutatorian, Evelyn Ramos. Evelyn has earned this honor by earning a 4.39 GPA during her 4 years at Firebaugh High School. This fall, Evelyn will be attending USC. Please help me in welcoming to the podium our 2021 class salutatorian, Evelyn Ramos.
Good afternoon, fellow graduates, faculty, family, and guests. After 2.5 years of in-person learning and 1.5 years of online learning, we finally find ourselves graduating. If I'm being honest, I never really imagined myself reaching this point in life. I thought the world would cease to exist, or it'd simply be my middle school self forever. Growing up and becoming an adult always seemed a lifetime away, and yet here I am today, a legal adult with adult responsibilities. It all happened really fast, too fast in my opinion, and I'm sure that a couple of my peers feel the exact same way. Now I understand that I seem to be starting off as a real downer, but it serves a purpose. It demonstrates that no matter what we may find ourselves believing or experiencing, life continues. Time will continue to pass, and we must be ready to face whatever it is that awaits us. This proved to be very true, especially during these times with COVID-19 and the pandemic as a whole. When the pandemic hit us the hardest, it seemed like everything was put on hold. In-person learning was canceled, major events were canceled, and almost every other aspect of our lives was canceled. Life in itself seemed to stop for a bit as we tried to process what was happening, but like I mentioned earlier, life would eventually have to continue. We'd have to work hard to get back to some kind of normality. And in the context of us students, getting back to some kind of normality would mean getting back into the school mentality. I myself admit that this wasn't easy. Being home 24/7, the thought of staying in bed and sleeping in or being on my phone was always on my mind. I lost a lot of my motivation and focus as even opening up my laptop seemed like a hassle. But I, like the class of 2021 before me, persevered. We worked hard to get where we are today, and that is no small feat. You should all be proud of yourselves. Life continued, pandemic and all, and you all made sure you still succeeded. While this success can be based on individual effort, there was a lot of support from outside sources that I want to acknowledge here today. Mrs. Storga and Ms. Comateros, thank you for being on my back 24/7 about applying to college. I practically owe you my acceptances. I don't even know where to begin with the amazing teachers that I've had throughout my high school experience. I will definitely be missing Ms. B's daily life lessons, Mr. Mascal's jokes and kind heart, and Mr. Barrera's several life anecdotes. And of course, I can't forget my English teacher, my AVID teacher, my mentor, and my friend all in one, Ms. Forbes. You often hear about that special teacher who will have a lasting impact on your life and whose guidance you will always cherish. That teacher to me is definitely Ms. Forbes. Last, but certainly not least, my family and friends. I wouldn't be here today without the constant love and support from my parents and my brothers. I simply don't understand how they put up with my constant nagging about school. I truly appreciate them. Para repetir, aunque sea una parte de lo que he dicho, le quiero dar las gracias a mis padres y a mis hermanos por su apoyo. Mis palabras simplemente no pueden expresar cuánto los quiero y aprecio. As for my friends, I have to give a quick shout out to Jade, Valerie, Jocelyn, Daniel, and Eric. I've grown so much love for you guys throughout the years, and I look forward to our continued friendship years and years beyond this point in time. Also, shout out to the class, to the AVID class of 2021. We really did become our own little family. To finally wrap this up, I want to congratulate my peers one last time because today, despite all that has happened, we find ourselves graduating. That is definitely something worth celebrating and being proud of. I wish you all the very best on whatever path it is you find yourself taking. Thank you all for listening, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the ceremony. As always, go Falcons. Thank you. Now please welcome back Principal Montes.
Thank you, Evelyn. The honor of class valedictorian is awarded to the student with the highest grade point average in the graduating class. It is my great honor to introduce to you this year's valedictorian, Angelica Peña. Angelica has earned this honor by earning a 4.42 GPA during her 4 years at Firebaugh High School. This fall, Angelica will be attending UC Berkeley. Please help me in welcoming to the podium our 2021 class valedictorian, Angelica Peña.
Good evening, parents, friends, teachers, and the graduating class of 2021. It is a privilege and an honor to be before you all today. I would like to start off by congratulating everyone. We all know that the journey here has not been easy, specifically these past 2 years. The pandemic completely changed our high school experience and brought forth many hardships. We had to remain strong and adapt to a new normal. However, the class of 2021 has shown resilience, and together we can finally say we've made it. I recall the first day of freshman year and being snapped awake as "Go Falcons" loudly rang through the speakers. All I could think about was the end of the day, where I would once more be awoken by the unforgettable "Go Falcons." I came into freshman year very apprehensive, timid, and like any other teenager, struggling to figure out my identity. During my time at Firebaugh High School, I began to come out of my comfort zone and started to figure out who I was, and more importantly, who I wanted to be. Like many of my peers, the knowledge I gained was far beyond what was taught in the classroom. One of the most important lessons I learned is the power of fostering relationships and connections. Looking back, there are so many memories that have come out of the relationships I've established here. I have learned to not take for granted the little moments we tend to overlook. Moments such as the lunchtimes filled with endless laughter, and of course, the mac and cheese Fridays. The pure adrenaline of working on Ms. Valle's packets during lunch on the day they were due, or seeing the entire class on the same Google Doc an hour before 11:59. I'm grateful for all these memories, and would like to thank everyone who has helped me get here. Firstly, to Ms. Astorga, for signing an endless amount of dual enrollment forms and always reminding me of my potential. To Ms. Camateros and Ms. Ramos, who were a tremendous help during the college application process. To Mr. G, who aside from being the best answer on campus, never failed to make me laugh or feel comfortable in his class. To Ms. B, Ms. Forbes, Mr. Ude, and the many other teachers who believed in me and supported me, I thank you all. To my friends, Anaisa, Natalie, Elizabeth, Denise, Angelica, Jenny, and Giselle, who made my high school experience fun. To Destiny for keeping me company on my nights full of calculus homework. To Ale and the engineering guys for making me feel included and making engineering exciting with all of their shenanigans. Lastly, I encourage you all to join me in thanking the family members and loved ones who have been part of our journey and have joined us here today. I would like to start off by thanking my siblings, Nick and Jessica, for always offering me a helping hand. Thank you, Mom, for always supporting me, no matter how hard it gets. I truly appreciate all that you do for me. Seeing how hardworking you are motivates me to continue and make you proud. Gracias, Papa, por todo el apoyo que me has dado. Gracias por llevarme a la escuela todos los días y por ser fuerte aunque tuvieras dificultades. Este triunfo no solo es mío, pero de nosotros porque todo esto ha sido posible con tu ayuda. Agradezco mucho todo lo que has hecho por mí. Los quiero mucho y espero poder seguir haciéndolos orgulloso en el futuro. I wish everyone the best, as this not only marks the end of a chapter, but also the beginning of a new one. I hope that our paths will cross in the future and we are able to make our Lynwood community proud. Thank you for all the memories. And once more, congratulations to the class of 2021. Thank you. Now please welcome back Principal Montes.
Thank you, Angelica. Before we present the diplomas for tonight's graduates, I would like to take a moment to tell you a little about this year's graduates and their accomplishments. You can find the names of these graduates in the graduation program denoted by special symbols. This year, we had 3 students earn AP Scholar Awards, which are granted to students who receive a score of 3 or higher on 3 or more advanced placement exams. The International Baccalaureate Program is an internationally recognized course of study designed to prepare students for higher education. The IB curriculum is an integrated, comprehensive, and balanced mix of sciences and humanities, and students are evaluated according to the highest international standards of assessment over a 2-year period. At Firebaugh High School, students may earn an IB diploma or choose to earn certificates in IB courses of their choosing. At this time, I would like to recognize the efforts of our IB course candidates, and I ask them to stand and be recognized for their efforts. And IB candidates can stand at this time. Thank you. To earn the IB diploma, students must pass examinations in 6 subject areas, write an extended essay of 4,000 words describing an independent research project, complete 150 hours of creative action and service activities, and take part in a critical thinking seminar called Theory of Knowledge. At this time, I would like to recognize the efforts of our IB diploma candidates, and I ask them to stand to be recognized for their efforts. These students have completed the most rigorous course of study at Firebaugh High School and, if successful, will start college as sophomores. Congratulations. Next, I would like to acknowledge our seniors that are members of the National Honor Society. These 31 seniors have been awarded the Distinguished Stole, which they earned by exemplifying the 4 pillars of scholarship, service, leadership, and character. Congratulations, National Honor Society members. This year, 69 students have earned the Golden State Seal of Merit on their diploma. They have earned this distinction by demonstrating masteries of the high school curriculum in at least 6 subject areas, including English language arts, mathematics, science, and U.S. history. These students will receive a special seal on their diploma. Congratulations, Golden State Seal Merit Diploma recipients. This year, 58 students have earned the Seal of Biliteracy on their diploma. They have earned this distinction by demonstrating a high level of proficiency in speaking, reading, and writing in 1 or more languages in addition to English. These students will receive a special seal on their diploma. Congratulations, California State Seal of Biliteracy Diploma recipients. This year, we had 12 seniors receive scholarships from various organizations and universities. Our students earned over $12,000 in scholarships this year. We also have a student who received the Gates Millennium Scholarship worth over $200,000. Congratulations to each of their accomplishments. Now, it is my pleasure to present to you this year's top 10 ranked graduating seniors. At number 10, attending UC Berkeley with a GPA of 4.26, Daniel Castillo. At number 9, attending UC Irvine with a 4.291 GPA, Jesus Rizzo. At number 8, attending UC Irvine with a 4.293 GPA, Richard Reynoso. At number 7, attending UCLA with a 4.32 GPA, Georgina Flores. At number 6, attending UCLA with a 4.34 GPA, Aneli Hernandez. At number 5, attending UCLA with a 4.36 GPA, Jocelyn Perez. At number 4, with a 4.37 GPA, Elena Luna. At number 3, attending UC Irvine with a 4.38 GPA, Angel Silva Huesca. At number 2, attending USC with a 4.39 GPA, Evelyn Ramos. And at number 1, attending UC Berkeley with a 4.42 GPA, Angelica Peña. Congratulations to our class of 2021 top 10 seniors. Each year, we ask our seniors to give us a glimpse on their plans. This year's senior survey tells us that 76 of our graduates plan to attend a two-year college with plans to transfer to a four-year university. The two-year colleges they plan to attend include Antelope Valley College, Cerritos College, Cypress College, East Los Angeles College, El Camino College, El Paso College, Los Angeles City College, Long Beach City College, Mesa College, and Scottsdale College. We also have six seniors enlisting in the armed forces, including the Air Force, Army, Coast Guard, Marine Corps, and Navy. 51 seniors will be attending nine California state universities this fall. Our 2021 graduates will be attending Cal State Dominguez Hills, Cal State Fullerton, Cal State Long Beach, Cal State LA, Cal State Northridge, Cal State Sacramento, Cal State San Bernardino, and Cal State San Marcos. 27 seniors will be attending seven UC campuses this fall. Our 2021 graduates will be enrolling in the following UC campuses: UC Berkeley, UC Davis, UC Irvine, UCLA, UC Merced, UC Riverside, and UC San Diego. Three seniors will be attending private universities across the country. This fall, graduates from the class of 2021 will be attending Pomona College and USC. Congratulations to all of our graduating seniors in the class of 2021. At this time, I would like to call Superintendent Dr. Gudiel R. Crossway to the podium for the presentation of the graduating class. As the principal of Firebaugh High School and on behalf of the administration and faculty, I hereby certify that today's students have met all of the graduation requirements established by the Board of Education and are eligible for graduation from the Lynwood Unified School District. I present to you all the students who have met the graduation requirements for the class of 2021.
Thank you, Dr. Montes. Good afternoon, everyone. Buenas tardes. Class of 2021, historic class of 2021. You have persevered and overcome incredible challenges. You have kept your dreams alive, and you are here tonight as an inspiration to all of us. We are extremely proud of you. And I'd like to ask our board who is with us here this afternoon, Mrs. Lopez, Dr. Castro, Mr. Hardy, and Mr. Del Real Calleros to join me at the podium as I accept the class of 2021. On behalf of the Board of Education, I am pleased to accept the Firebaugh class, the historic class of 2021, and to award to its members the diploma verifying completion of all graduation requirements of the Lynwood Unified School District. The entire Board of Education congratulates these students who have achieved this milestone. The board also wishes success and happiness to all of this year's graduates and their families. Congratulations, felicidades.
Thank you, Superintendent Crossway. Seniors, please be seated. Now, here is the moment you have all been waiting for. I would like to ask for the assistance of our board members and district office administration to help present the diplomas to this year's graduating class. Here to announce the names of this year's graduates are our esteemed faculty members, Ms. Daisy Astorga and Mr. Luis Perez. Thank you.
Yeah, I'll switch with her.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be on this side. Okay.
Andrea Andrade.
Angelica Peña.
Maria Rivera.
Evelyn Ramos.
Graciela Araujo López.
Kayla Murillo.
Ronald Buchanan.
Cynthia Irazo Cabrera.
Elijah Dickerson.
Diego Castro.
Semi J. Miles.
Jaime Cruz.
Ruby Hernandez.
Kevin Gutierrez.
Joseph Harold.
Alvaro Cervantes Jr.
Alexis Ruano.
Eduardo Favela Atencio.
Luis Fernando Ramirez.
Joel Mecinas.
Cristian Rodríguez.
Eduardo de León.
Abraham Ramírez.
Tylee Zúñiga.
Tyler Gómez.
Rachel Valenzuela.
Christopher Wyatt.
Luis Leyva.
Anthony Carrillo.
Adrian Diaz.
Matthew Escalante.
Damon Suazo.
Robert Marquez.
Jesus Lopez Rivera.
Yaslin Lopez.
Rodrigo Arellano.
Yafni Cerezo.
Reina Espinosa.
Brandon Velasco.
George Gonzalez.
Miguel Nava.
Brian Granados.
Kevin Penalosa.
Giovanni Reyes.
Viviana K. Campos.
Kevin Alvarez.
Litzairi Aranza.
Gabriel Zamora Barón.
Eric Jauregui.
Daniel Arellano.
Yulisa Garcia.
Adrian Garcia.
Denise Delgado.
David Martinez.
Jennifer Esquivel Lázaro.
Jason Velarde.
Angélica Mendoza Rojas.
Andrew Garcia.
Giselle López.
Angel Rodriguez. Pérez.
Brianna Vázquez. Kevin Ibanez.
Gerardo Jimenez.
Agustin Martinez.
Arturo Garcia.
Alexander Zamora.
Brian Garcia.
Edgar Zamora.
David Magana.
Ambrosio López.
Alejandra Zacarías.
Joel Dueñas.
Genesis Arellano.
Adriana Ceja Carrillo.
Yamilex Uriarte.
María Ruiz.
Daniel Moreno.
Lisbeth Peña.
Vanessa Arvizu García.
Perla Vidovich.
Emma Ulloa.
Gabriel Montiel.
Angie Peña.
Amy Sanchez.
Yahaira Ortega.
Mark Kaibus.
Eileen Ponce.
Darius Newell.
Jade Araujo.
Leonardo Arellano.
Gislaine Arriaga.
Ricardo Ruiz.
Anastasia Wosu.
Matthew Solis.
Natalia de la Torre.
Christopher Rebollar.
Heidi Cartagena.
Adolfo Cienfuegos.
Andrés Bertán Flores.
Juan Galindo. Desiree Flores.
Kristen Garcia.
Orlando Gonzalez.
Catherine Vasquez.
Morelia Navarrete.
Christian Bravo.
Andy Garza.
Larry Gonzalez. Karina Carmona. Azul Alvarez. Citlali Solis.
Congratulations to all of our seniors. Before we complete our ceremony today, we have two more important items to complete. First, the playing of our school's alma mater and the traditional tassel ceremony. Here to lead us in these two activities is our senior class president, Cynthia Erazo Cabrera.
Hello, my name is Cynthia Razo Cabrera, and I am the Firebaugh High School Senior Class President. Please join me in welcoming Firebaugh High School Band as they play our alma mater.
Mater.
Thank you.
Members of Class of 2020-21, at this time, I ask that you move your tassel from the right side of your, from the right side to the left side of your mortar board. This action signifies that you are now a graduate of Firebaugh High School. Congratulations, Firebaugh High School Falcon alumni.
Thank you, great job.
Thank you, seniors. Congratulations to you all and your families. Parents, guests, and faculty members, I am pleased to present to you the Firebaugh High School Class of 2021. At this time, we will dismiss our graduates to the parking lot in the back, where they will wait to be dismissed once the campus is cleared. We will dismiss families by section. We must clear all bleachers and campus before we dismiss our graduates. Due to COVID-19 restrictions in campus construction, we will not allow for families and graduates to congregate on our campus. When you are dismissed, please walk to your cars where you can wait for your graduate. We will now begin to dismiss Section A. Everyone else, please remain seated. So Section A, you can exit the stadium.
TV, sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all ever since I was young. They said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it. That was never friendly. Yeah, now I'm jumping out of Bentley, yeah. And I know I sound dramatic, yeah. But I know I had to have it, yeah. For the money, I'm a savage, yeah. I be itching like I had it.
Now we will dismiss Section B, yeah. And you can walk towards the parking lot, everyone towards like the west of the stadium.
But all that mean nothing when I saw my door, yeah. Everyone counting on me, drop the ball, yeah. Everything custom like I'm at the bottom. Yeah, yeah. If you quit winning, put your lighters to the sky. How could I make sense when I got millions on my mind?
Come in, now we will dismiss Section C from the stadium. Thank you.
My mama called, see you on TV. Sunset done changed ever since we was on. I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication.
And now we will dismiss all remaining sections from the stadium, and you can meet your graduates in your car.
Yeah, oh, I was patient. Hey, oh. Now I can scream that we made. Say congratulations. Young graduation. Yeah. I pick up the rock and I ball, baby. I'm looking for someone to call, baby. But right now I got a situation. Number old Ben Franklin. Cash. Big rings, champagne. My life is like a ball game. But instead I'm in a trap, though. Pass so big, call it Super Bowl. Super Bowl.